Shem Stars. Welcome to class, and today we will continue with our chapter.
We are doing chapter number 6, political parties, and this is part 3. Today we will cover following topic. We'll discuss about regional and state parties and the challenges to political parties.
We talk about state parties, the party which originate in a particular region or state and work for it and its people is called regional political party. A party that secure at least 6% of the total votes in an election to the legislative assembly of a state and win at least 2 seats is recognized as a state party. Example, Jammu and Kashmir National Conference and Jharkhand Mukti Morcha. These are some of the examples of state or regional party. Now we talk about state parties with national level organization. Some of the regional parties are All India Party that happen to have succeeded only in some states. Parties like the Samajwadi Party, Samata Party, Rashtriya Janata Dal have national level political organization with units in several states. Some of these parties like Biju Janata Dal, Sikkim Democratic Front and Mizo National Front are conscious about their state identity. Over the last 3 decades, the number and strength of these parties has expanded. This made the Parliament of India politically more and more diverse. No national party is able to secure on its own a majority in Lok Sabha. As a result, the national parties are compelled to form alliance with state parties.
Since 1996, nearly every of the state party has got an opportunity to be a part of one or the other national level coalition government.
Now we discuss the challenges to political party. There are 3 challenges, that is lack of internal democracy, dynastic succession and money and muscle power. First we talk about lack of internal democracy within parties. In most of the political parties, the power is concentrated in the hand of one or few leaders at the top. Ordinary members of the party do not get sufficient information about the happening inside the party. Parties do not conduct internal election regularly. More than loyalty to party principles and policies, personal loyalty to the leader become more important. As a result, the leaders assume greater power to make decisions in the name of party. Due to all these reasons, political parties face these challenges. Then second challenge is dynastic succession. The top position in many political parties are generally controlled by member of one family. Leaders on the top have unfair chance of favoring their families and friends. This is also bad for democracy, since people who do not have adequate experience or popular support come to occupy position of power. This tendency is present in some measures all over the world, including in some of the older democracies. The transfer of power and authority from father to son throughout the generations. Jewish history known of royal dynasties, especially the dynasty of King David, from whom all the kings of Judah were descended in direct succession. This is an example of dynasty succession. Then we talk about the third challenge, that is muscle and money power. This is a prominent challenge to political parties during election. Since parties are focused only on winning election, they tend to use shortcuts to win elections. Such shortcuts include that they tend to nominate those candidates who have or can raise lots of money. Rich people and companies who give funds to the parties tend to have influence on the policies and decisions of the party. In some cases, parties support criminals who can win elections.
That's all with today's session. If there is any kind of doubt, feel free to ask. Take care.